Keep praying, keep praying. I know what's happening. Everybody pray. Everybody shout. Everybody lift your voice. Jesus said to Capernaum, O Prince of Darkness, you have been exalted to the highest of heavens. Now you shall be brought down to Hades. There is a spirit on this region. And the Spirit of God said, you shall say, as Jesus said, I saw Satan fall as if struck by lightning from heaven. This night, says the Spirit of God. Come on! Go! praise out. Come on. Of darkness, you have the right to stand before the children of light. The prince of darkness, you have no right to stand before the children of light. Shout! Yeah! Prince of darkness, you have no right to stand before the children of light. You gotta come down from your lofty place as they lift their voice and give him praise. Come on, everybody. Tonight's a little different. Let me tell you something. We have encountered a demonic power that has made declaration that the people of God who have a little bit of light shall have that light taken away from them. But God said, my people shall retaliate tonight. My people shall retaliate tonight, and you will bring that force down to where it belongs, in hell where it belongs, says the Spirit of God. Come on! Prince of darkness, you have no right. Said, Prince of darkness, you have no right. Said, Prince of darkness, you have no right. Everybody prophesy with me. Prince of darkness, you have no right to chant before the children of light. You shall be brought down from your place by the sounds of the highest praise. Everybody lift your voice and praise him. Come on. Come on, it's going to happen tonight. I want you to know something. Tomorrow about this time, the atmosphere is going to be cleared up. And God said there will be an opening into the heavens. For this cloud that is trying to come and take from you will be taken away tonight, says the Lord. And I will send the lightning from the sky. There will be lightning from the sky, and you will know that there is light that is in the house. There is light that is in the sky. There is light that is in the sky. There is light that is in the sky. Everybody lift your voice and praise him. Come on. Come on. This is the time of prophetic pronouncement tonight. Come on. Come on. America, you will stand united in victory. There will be no infiltration of the beast of the east. For tonight we declare there is no victory for you whatsoever. Come on. Come on. Come and embark upon the territories of God. Forces of evil, you would dare to come and embark upon the places called the high places where the prophets dwell. You would come into the place and try and stifle the words of the prophetic voice. Even in the northeast, you have no power to do that to the prophets of the Most High God. Come on! Everybody, come on, throw those hands up. good. Everybody clap your hands. I know a lot of you don't know what's happening right now. But out of the sky, there was a dark cloud that appeared. And that started coming over us. And the Spirit of the Lord said tonight, the enemy has endeavored to keep his position over this northern eastern region. But tonight, as I did in the days of old, and as the people gathered around my prophet, so as they begin to declare war, I brought down the territorial principalities. And tonight I'm bringing down the territorial principalities and bringing them to nothing, so that you can trample them under your feet, says the Spirit of God. So you're ready to trample them under your feet. Under my feet, get under my feet, get under my feet. Now I want you to begin to dance for the Lord. Come on, come on. Tonight strikes you down. The light of their praise, the light of their voice, the light of their hearts, the light of their faith, the light of their understanding is striking you down right now. Come on. America, you are yet a chosen nation. America, you are yet set apart to destroy the presence of evil. Do not shy away. Do not run away from this great goal. You are my battle axe. You are my weapons of war. For this which you have done in going to war, I shall return to you favors. But the first of my treasures shall be given to my people. America, I told you I would return, for your day of visitation is over. Now there is a habitation of supreme miraculous intervention. I will send miracles for your economy. I will send miracles for technology. And you will use these weapons to subdue the powers of evil. Rejoice, for I'm sending angels to this nation again to dig into the soil, to the hard soil, and you will plow as Judah plowed, and the soil shall become greatly fertile. And the Lord says, in your soil you will produce energy that will go throughout the earth, and you will be the source of energy to the earth, says the Lord. Come on, say yes. Listen to your prophets. They're gathering around your prophet, and the voice that they hear is bringing life to them. Open up the gates of righteousness. Open up the gates of righteousness. I will go in. Open up the gates of righteousness, and I will righteousness and open up the gates. Open up the gates. And I'll go in. Says I'm opening up something. Won't you look into the heavens? You will see. Is there a cloud in the sky? Is there a cloud? Is there a cloud? Prophet stands. Come to the altar. There are lampstands. Come to the altar. There is light. Come to the altar. altar, stand with the prophet. For families will know of tonight. And as you stand at the altar, stand with your light. As you stand at the altar, there is no need to fight. Tonight, and there will be light. There will be oil that will be given to you. Diabolical, wicked force that has endeavored to encroach upon your people who had planned wicked things. The Spirit of God sends a message to me. In the severity of this battle, angels stood watching for many over the centuries and over the millennia. Did what you did. They stood watching on mountains and on hilltops, watching armies being brought to nothing by enemies that were nothing. And in dismay turned away and said, "What has become of Judah? What has become of Jerusalem? What has become of Israel?" And so you have watched in despair as you have seen this nation falling in humility, being blamed, while blameless in many ways. And yet the same stronghold wishes to grab a hold of the neck of my people and throttle them and say, "No more of your praise, no more of your expression. But God said, I will take you to New York and place you at Times Square. And they shall say, who are these people? And they will not know that I cannot be banished from my cities, cities that I raised up through your forefathers, and whose blood was shed on the soil of these cities. Do you think I can be banished, says the Lord? So therefore they have said no more, and I say, because you have said no more, so much more shall be done. Because you have banished me from your schools, so much more will I come in. Turn me up. Because you have taken me out of your legal system, so much more will I come back. Because you have banished me and you have said you cannot come into our government, God said, so much more I will do it, and it shall be done. It shall be done through my prophets, says the Spirit of the Lord. Therefore tonight, I speak to this nation. I speak to America. I am about to take you to a place you have never been. I'm about to take you to a place that you have never been. And they will say, but the revival is not within the four walls of the church. So where is it? God says, I have taken to the streets. I have taken to the streets. Where there will be women like the woman at the well. Where there will be blind Bartimaeuses, where there will be tax collectors who will pay back 5 to 10 to 20 times more. The restoration that is beginning comes as a result of a demonic force, a prince of the air. That lofty position was given by governing officials of this region, and because of church leaders and gatekeepers, they gave them that position. But tonight the prophet came in and stood with the people of God and tore down the prince of this region. Therefore shout, shout, shout. Come on. Says they will not tear down the gates of my city. They will not tear down the gates of my city. I will place gatekeepers in every city that I have cherished. And God said they will not allow the enemy to come in. For the gatekeepers have allowed my enemies to come in. But tonight God said the watchmen's on the wall. The watchmen on the wall have broken the power of that thing once and for all. Rejoice, America, for your street shall be filled with a baptism of fire, says the Lord of hosts. Come on! whisperer came into the garden and divided even the best of friends. Take somebody by the hand, please. I'm going to stand and pray with your people now. Raise your hands up with me, please. Come on, lift your hands up now with them, with that person's hand. To us tonight, Lord, that this nation, America, is going to be the salt of the earth once again. We are tired of being told that we are second class, second grade. And Father, we have heard so many times about how you're going to move in the revival that took place down in Florida, and then another revival over here in little sparks. But God, you also made a proclamation that there would be a generation of your children that we as the prophets owe to break down the territorial demonic powers that have been given and eaten, who have not been evicted, but they have been given the power by our own leaders of this nation, the media, and given them the torch, and they have lit fires everywhere to destroy this nation. And so, Lord, tonight you brought me here to stand before your people and declare to them, one principality that is held strong, one principality that has even divided the hearts of those who run this nation and run the church, now have been brought, that spirit, brought to complete and utter subservience, brought to utter nothing. And in the presence of these people, I fought through, Lord, and brought the light. Now, as you have spoken that this nation would change, you told me many months ago that the enemy would come and he'd lay his hand and his sword on the Kennedy family. And God, I'm praying that you would do something miraculous. Mighty Damascus Road conversion of a kind that will shake this nation. We speak not against Catholicism or one of the religions, but you have had your stronghold for too long. And in the Northeast tonight, I as a prophet make a declaration upon the Northeast that the Kennedys will have a flame of fire and a baptism that shall come from the Holy Spirit that will shake both Democratic and Republican parties. And the Spirit of the Lord said, because of that spirit that was brought down tonight, I will do it if you will pray for it. I will do it, says the Spirit of God, and do a miraculous thing for that family, says the Lord. Come on. One of the final prayers of Tony Snow was that God would heal Edward Kennedy, that God would move amongst that family. And God said, surely I can wash their sins whiter than snow. Surely I can do this thing. But why do I tell you this, says the Lord, for I share my secrets with my servants, the prophets. And even tonight, as I share this with you, reach out for the oil that is present at this altar, God says, is the oil that I shall give to my people in such power, in such movement, in so much quantity that you shall say, we cannot take any more oil for our lamps. We cannot take any more oil, because God said, you shall have an abundance, an abundance. I prophesied it. I spoke it. Now take it. Reach out and receive it right now. Come on, everybody, lift your hands. Lift your hands and receive it right now. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Lift your hands. Come on. Take it. Take it. Take the oil of the Lord, for it has been given out by the Spirit of the living God. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Come on, go, 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 go. Keep praying, keep praying, keep praying, keep praying. Keep praying, keep praying. Keep praying, take it. There's something happening right now. All over this place. God said, it's yours, it's yours, it's yours. Come on. Lift your voice. Come on, give Him praise. Your hands, come on, praise Him. For every family that stood in prayer and you said it, what about me? What about my house? God said, tonight it is not only written in my word, but it is spoken and pronounced by a prophetic voice that you trust, that an unusual manifestation shall take place in the families of those that stood on the battlefield, stood in the front line. Your sons and your daughters, as I said last night, the Samuels, the Davids, the Ruths, the Miriams, the Esthers, the Marys, all the greats of yesteryear, to come back and raise your children up by the Spirit of God to do even greater than they did. Is that possible? Then I want you to say these words: as for me and my house, we will walk with God. We will serve Him. We will make known His ways. My children will prophesy to dead bones. My children will raise the dead. My children will walk upright and strike down the very presence of evil. This is our honor. We receive it now. Come on. Yes, I receive it. Lift your voice, lift your voice, lift your voice. Come on. to prophesy over this nation right now. Come on, hallelujah. Sing it. America, America, you are the salt of the earth. Sing it, everybody. America, America, you are the light of the world. Sing it again. America, America, you are the salt of the earth. Sing it again. America, America, you are the light of the world. Come on! You make that declaration and you watch what God does in this nation. Come on, sing it again. America, America, you are the salt of the earth. Sing it again.
America, America,
we are the light of the world. Sing it again. America,
America,
we are the salt of the earth. America, America, we are the light of the world. Come on! Say yes! Say yes! 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 Come on! Yeah! That's your word! That's your word! Come on! Praise and the glory that you deserve, oh God. The praise and the glory that you deserve, oh God. We give it to you, we give it to you, we give it to you. We give you the praise, Lord. We receive the oil. We receive the oil, we receive it right now. Brothers and sisters, for standing with me. Thank you for standing with me in this time where we stood face to face. So what did the prophet come to give us? The prophet delivered to you and then took you with him to a great battlefield in the heavenlies. Believe it or not, some of you may not feel it and understand it. But sometimes God calls me into a place and says, go to struggle, battle, and pull down the very thing that is stopping and hindering them from getting the promise. You see, yes, 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 come on. God said these words to me this afternoon when I was praying. He said, great, great opposition. Why? Because of great, great multitudes of promises that are in existence, but that have not yet come to pass. In Isaiah 46, it says these words. He says, I, the Lord, determine something. I speak it to bring it into existence, and I purpose it. And once it is brought into existence, it still has to come to pass. In other words, your promise, your property, whatever He has promised you, whatever you prayed for, and He has spoken it into existence, it's present. And you are a witness to that event, which means you carry the presence of that event or thing that is in existence to your now. You are a witness to your destiny. You've been there. Why? Because it's in existence, but has not yet come to pass. He brings it to pass. And the Spirit of the Lord clearly said to me, Kim, once you have bashed and broken the power, the principality that has stood hovering over this region, because it has been allowed by gatekeepers that refused to pray and fast, by gatekeepers that would compromise, by political leaders that have given it its position, once you have broken it, he said, things and promises that I have spoken and are in existence will begin to come to pass. And you know, we so many times we hear these promises and we say, oh, well, I don't know. Listen to me. You can feel as much as I can the presence of this battle and then the sudden victory we had. We were bashing against something, and I began to realize when Jesus stood before the disciples and he said, go into the cities, and then he stood outside and said, Capernaum, prince of the air, you who have been exalted to your lofty place shall be brought down to Hades. And the disciples returned, listen to them, with joy. And do you know what they said? Even the demons are subject to us in your name. What was the change? What made that happen? Christ as a prophet stood outside the city while they were laboring in that city and made a pronouncement against the principality that stood over that region and brought it to nothing. And when they returned to Jesus with joy, he made this statement, I saw Satan fall as if struck by light from heaven. In other words, your labor, my prophecy or pronouncement against the spirit brought a shift in the cities and the atmosphere, and the forces of evil that had held tight territorially in the territory, in the principality, in the municipality, every place suddenly had no right, and suddenly were subservient to the disciples and followers of Christ. And then they were subject to them in their name, in his name. I want to say to you tonight that I honestly believe that the powers of hell that have had hold of us, and you've had difficulty getting property sold and whatever it is, I believe that that is going to change within a few days, my friend, because I saw this principality fall as if struck by lightning from heaven out to hell. Come on, hallelujah. So be it. Don't rejoice over that. Rejoice at your names. In other words, what he was trying to say was, God's signature's on your life. You have been inscribed in life, in the book of life. This is nothing. None of you will walk out of this building without having a it shall come to pass moment of what is already in existence. That's a promise from God. Now I want you to think, what things are in existence in your life? What things are in existence but not yet come to pass? I suggest to you that that in existence shall come to pass very, very shortly. Yes. For the Absalom spirit that has also stood and watched with an eye shall hang by its neck. very shortly. That's what the Spirit of God tells me now. The Absalom spirit that is standing watching and trying to speak here and speak there and pull is about to be hanged. No breath, no power. For it has held on to my people and tried to divide and destroy and usurp authority. The authority that exists now shall exist even greater, with greater authority and greater power and greater dimension, says the Spirit of God. Come on! Yes! So strongly that God's saying to me, things that are in existence are going to come to pass. And you know what, people, I need that desperately. I myself, my wife, my family, my ministry, under tremendous suppression attack. And things that are in existence, we quote them, we pray them, we say them. But there's got to be a suddenly moment where that thing just suddenly appears. The promise was that on the day of Pentecost, he said, when the day of Pentecost had fully come. Everybody say, when the day had fully come. That's the issue. Right there is the issue, because that was the completion of a day. The promise came from being in existence to coming to pass. And you know what it says? It says tongues of fire came into that place, and one tongue sat on each one of them. Do you know that with a promise that is in existence, there is an expression that comes with that, that rests upon each one of you? Each personally has a divine expression that comes with the promise coming to pass. You never have a promise come to pass without an expression that rests upon you and gives you an authoritative speech and an ability to persuade for what you've been through. Come on. The other thing, Jesus said these words. Jesus said just before he was crucified, he said to his disciples, he said, you, because you have endured with me through my trials. Your trial is not just your trial. It's the trial of Christ. Jesus said to them, because you have endured with me through my trials, I bestow upon you a kingdom. In other words, my friend, your fight, your labor is not in vain. Because once you've endured through that day, he bestows upon you a kingdom or a reign, an authority that you didn't have before. I suggest to you tonight that that very thing is happening in this building. I suggest to you tonight that we don't even realize that a baptism of fire is about to take place, because this day is fully come. Come on, hallelujah. Say yes. That's what I suggest to you. Everybody say yes.
Yes.
Again.
Yes.
Again. Yes, 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 yes. Come on. You got it tonight. Come on. Hallelujah. There are a lot of you in this building that have in existence a promise for healing. There are a lot of you in this building that have in existence a promise for prosperity and breakthrough in your relationships, for your family, for your children. How about us realizing that in existence must come to pass sometime? And I suggest to you that if God told me as a prophetic voice to you that suddenly is the word for this convention, that I would suggest to you, you better be expecting it, because suddenly is about to happen for you. Come on. Hallelujah. Yes. Come on. Hey, hey. I think you know what I'm saying tonight. There's a breakthrough in this place, and that's all there is to it. Come on, hallelujah. I believe it. I believe it's done. I believe it's coming to pass.
Over 40 years ago, Kim and I embarked on a ministry journey that has now become a global network through the power of the internet. As part of this pioneering work, we are gathering people from all over the world to worship together, grow in our faith, and inspire hope through an uplifting message. We are dedicated to reaching out with God's message of hope and love to all without discrimination or judgment. We invite you to join our House of Destiny free membership that allows you to connect with members from around the world. Through our prayer wall, you can post your requests and have others join us in prayer. It's so powerful when the saints gather and believe for a breakthrough. We invite you to join today. Simply click the online church login and sign up. We are here for you, and we have worked hard to provide the resources and tools to help you grow in your faith. Join us today and be part of a community that inspires hope, brings restoration to life, and often healing from the past. Together, we can make a difference, and we thank you for your ongoing support.
U.S. and we listen. We're finally bringing the most requested offer ever. Get the queen size premium MyPillow, now only $19.98. MyPillow is made with patented adjustable fill. It adjusts to your exact individual needs regardless of your sleep position. It helps keep your neck aligned and holds its shape all night long so you get the best sleep of your life. But that's not all. Get our six-piece kitchen or bath towel sets, only $25. Our brand new mattress topper as low as $69.98. Get our famous MyPillow bed sheets for as low as $25, and so much more. So go to MyPillow.com or call the number on your screen. Use your promo code to get huge discounts on all MyPillow products, including the premium queen-size MyPillow, only $19.98. That's the lowest price ever. Don't delay. Order today. From all of us here at MyPillow, thanks, America!
We here at the House of Destiny are partnering with you to let our viewers, of course, know about your company. It's Beverly Hills Precious Metal.
Andrew, explain how that works.
So I'll walk you through it right now. So if you go to bh-pm.com, right there on the homepage, you'll see a form that you could fill out. And that form is very important in letting us know how we can help you. So you just put in your first name, last name, email address, phone number. There's a section that says, how did you hear about us? And in there, put Kim Clement. And then there's a portion where you could write a couple of notes down on the bottom. Usually within about 24 to 48 hours, we'll contact you by phone call. And then we'll go over everything with you. This isn't a high pressure deal. We always recommend that if you feel uncomfortable, take a step back, pray about it. You will gain the answers that you need by doing that, and come back to us when you're comfortable.